Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, wherever you're joining us from around the world, and welcome to the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. I'm Brendan Batchelor, the voice of the Vancouver Canucks on Sportsnet 650 Radio, joined by the one and only Nasher, of course, 450,000 subscribers on YouTube. You know him from the NHL Gaming World Championships as well. Nasher, thanks for joining me. This is going to be a lot of fun today.
Yeah, this is huge, man. We've seen the esports scene continue to grow here over the last month or two. The Gaming Stadium doing a great job of putting this together with pros and the community as well. And really excited to see how the guys perform today.
Yeah, we've got a great charitable component to the show today as well. Raising money for frontline workers through Canada Helps. You can donate by clicking on the link below the stream if you're watching right now, or you can go and visit CanadaHelps.org as well. And, you know, great to be able to help out some of those frontline workers who are doing such a great job to keep us safe during this unprecedented time right now.
100%. Yeah, obviously with everything going on, like, we want to be able to make a difference and seeing both the community, everyone here that's watching this, and all the pros come together to support a great cause. This is what it's all about. So glad to be here.
We've got four National Hockey League players today that are going to be playing each other at NHL 20. The first matchup coming up in minutes, Jake Virtanen of the Vancouver Canucks against Tyler Seguin of the Dallas Stars. And then later on, Thomas Chabot of the Ottawa Senators and Pierre-Luc Dubois of the Columbus Blue Jackets. Those will be the two semifinal matchups. And then the two winners of those games will play each other in the final. And then the winner of that game will play the winner of community event, which is going on right now. So a cool opportunity for someone to get to play against an NHL player.
Yeah, and I think this is going to be an interesting matchup today. We've heard a bit of chirping already. Virtanen, actually an Xbox player, just now coming over to the PS4. Seguin says he hasn't really gamed in quite a few years here. So I think both of them have a couple things working against them, but it should be a fun matchup here today.
And we should as well mention our sponsors for the broadcast today: Shaw, Red Bull, EB Games, GameStop, and AccuSpike, doing a great job contributing to this. So we'll start getting things going here in just a few moments as we'll welcome in Jake Virtanen of the Vancouver Canucks, already having a career year this year offensively with Vancouver. Tyler Seguin, who was the leading scorer for the Dallas Stars when the season was shut down. Guys, thanks for joining us today. This should be a lot of fun.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
So, Jake, let's start with you. What's your level of confidence going to this game today?
It's pretty low, not going to lie. I'm a little nervous. I feel like Tyler could be on some skill in his game. So, I guess we'll see what happens here.
How about you, Tyler?
I feel like I was pretty good a decade ago. I haven't played much. I still use the 94 controls. I think it's maybe hybrid now. I played last night, first time in like I said, about 10 years, but I'm excited. One game.
How'd you do last night?
I lost the computer, 6-2.
All right, so both of these guys played the computer last night, and both of them lost. So, I mean, with both of them going together head-to-head right now, somebody's got to come out on top. So we'll see what happens.
We'll see what happens.
Yeah, it should be a good matchup coming up. I'll ask you first, Tyler. You say you don't game a lot, but do you have any teammates on the Dallas Stars that are really into the game, and anybody that's really good at it?
Yeah, Steven Johns and Jamie Oleksiak are gamers. I think they played in a NBC or NHL tournament that's going on right now, and I think they won. They play on the road, too. I see it on the plane sometimes, so they're definitely our gamers.
How about you, Jake? Anyone on the Canucks that's pretty good at this game, other than yourself, if you want to pat your back?
Yeah, I'm not even close. Thatcher Demko, he's pretty good. I remember a couple years ago, I think he was top 10 in the world, actually, in like 2018, I think, in the game. And then Brock Besser, I think they played together online. So those two gamers on our team.
All right.
Yeah, well, we actually played against...
Go ahead.
Sorry, I was going to say we played against Demko and Besser maybe 2 weeks ago in a little ESHL matchup, and they actually beat us. So I can't confirm there's some good players there. They're really good.
Yeah, they're pretty good.
All right, well, let's get to the game here as quick as we can. I'm assuming you guys are going to play as the Vancouver Canucks and the Dallas Stars, and that is indeed what we have here. Hoping to score goals with yourself. Give yourself a little bit more ice time, both of you, than than maybe you would normally get?
Yeah, I think I'm just going to keep myself on the third or whatever I'm at. I'll leave the lines how they are.
Are you guys happy with your, do you know your ratings in the game, and are you happy with them?
I have no clue, to be honest, but it doesn't really matter. I guess we'll find out. I actually haven't really taken a look at the, ratings or anything, but that's all right.
Oh shoot. What is going on?
As we have a few technical difficulties, it looks like here.
Sagan, you just hop over to the left side there and then hit X and it should ready you up there.
Am I not?
You might have to pick your jersey first. No, you are good.
Watch the X button, okay? Wait.
Jake, have you hit X yet? Yeah, there you go.
I'm ready.
Am I good?
I think you just got to go down. You got to click down or let's see. Hold on. Oh, yeah, I have no clue. There you go.
Oh, there it is. Oh, no. Yeah. This is not a good sign of things to come right here.
No, it's not. At least you're all being honest now.
Yeah, I respect that. So, hey, I saw you were doing go ahead and hit X and you'll start it up there. I think one of you. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. I saw you were doing some hand stretches already. So, yeah, this is looking very promising.
All right, let's go.
Here we are.
I got like the pregame jitters right now.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like this is a big game, you know?
It is. It is.
Are you either of you guys get nervous before big games? Like good nervous or how are you before a big game in real life?
Tyler, you can start.
I don't think I call it nervous, but like a good anxiousness, especially for big games. Kind of just how it goes with big games. You know, you're thinking about that, and you know, it kind of fuels me for sure.
Here we are,
as we get the game underway, and opening faceoff goes to Jake Virtanen, and his Canucks come in early. He scores just 30 seconds into the game, and
back
it's 1-0
for
Jake Virtanen.
Wins the draw, takes it up the ice. First shot, first goal for Jake here. I think Tyler's a little rattled here, calling a timeout, getting the boys rallied up. You gotta get it going quick to recover from that one.
Was that Chris Tanev? Chris Tanev up in the rush. You don't see that very often.
You can hit it with a quick pause if you need to. Are you on the skill stick or something? You know, you think that's why you got scored on?
I don't know. I wasn't switching players like I thought I would.
Maybe you can figure that out.
Wait, how do I pause it? Oh, I can't pause it.
You only get one pause a game. You might have already used it. You can have Jake pause for you at a whistle if you want to reset it.
Yeah.
Okay. Good play there.
Tyler's able to clear the puck, so Jake will have to break out from his own zone. Quick icing call there. And a huge hit as Sega takes Quinn Hughes into the end board.
There you go. Go settings, controller settings, and then you can change it to hybrid.
While we're getting that sorted, Jake, you had Chris Tanev set up the goal there, joking that he's not up in the rush very much, but he did score a really nice overtime goal earlier this season.
Yeah, he did. We all made fun of him for like a week celebration, actually. I think he had I think it was like an overtime goal, I think, this year, and it was he said every time he scores, he just blacks out and doesn't know what to do. So, pretty funny.
I think we've got things back on the straight and narrow here.
How do you think it's wrong?
Another face-off win for Jake Virtanen, and Quinn Hughes fires it wide of the net from the point. And
terrible.
Jake controlling the game early here, but still plenty of time left for Tyler to battle back.
No. We're playing Stars hockey. Rely on Bishop.
And a big save there from Ben Bishop. You're used to seeing that.
Gotta say, I like what I'm seeing from Jake so far already here. You know, back and forth action. He's just keeping it in the zone. He's got full control. I think he was hustling Tyler a little bit, saying he's not very good at this game. Very early on here, he's got full control of this thing.
No, honestly, my buddy, we played a little bit on Xbox, and he just beats me every time. So maybe that's just how it goes.
Oh my god. Go. I keep trying to pass it and I keep icing it.
And so we'll have another face-off coming up. Jake's been 100% in the draw so far, I think.
Are you supposed to press the button or?
It's the right stick. See, oh, there you go.
Oh, no problem. There we go. Oh, it's the right stick.
There we go. Oh. As Tyler loses the puck on the wing there, and back comes Jake with Bo Horvat down the right wing. Trying to find some room in the slot. Out of the right circle. Nice little move over to the side there again. Early in the first period here of the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. Jake Virtanen with a 1-0 lead on Tyler Seguin. The winner of this game will move on to face the winner of Thomas Chabot and Pierre-Luc Dubois. That game coming up a little bit later on. As Tyler brings the puck to center. And a chance to tee one up in the slot. Shot right on. And a stop by Jacob Markstrom in the Vancouver net as Jake Virtanen transitions back up the ice. You're getting a little bit more into the feel of the game now, Tyler?
A little bit, yeah. I'm getting my bearings.
Well, there's a good chance right in front, but a nice blocker save from Jacob Markstrom. Sorry. And Jake Virtanen back with the puck again.
Oh, there we go. Fun.
As now another chance through the slot area. Good back check by Jamie Benn to strip the puck.
Oh, give it to this guy.
Jake Virtanen has the puck. Nice move into the slot. Virtanen shoots it. It was blocked in. Good defensive play. And back come the Stars. Tyler Seguin controlling them to center. Turn the puck over.
How about
here's
a little coast to coast with himself? Go for it. Couple toe drags.
Oh. Nice dump clearing.
Surprised he was going to make the pass there after gaining the blue line.
There we go.
Thought you were going to try to go all the way in on net there, Jake. Here's a chance. Seguin in front. Kicked out by
there
Markstrom. And it's a 3-on-2. Jake Virtanen with the puck. Pass in front and a nice defensive play there. Tyler Seguin doing a good job defending here. Jake's had lots of zone time. But we haven't had a goal since the first 30 seconds of the game. Now late in the first period. Here's Jay Beagle with the puck for Vancouver. The fourth line on the ice right now.
Oh, there's that Hughes.
Oh, here we go.
Power play coming up. Tripping penalty going against Ellis, it looks like there. So Jake will get the man advantage. Do you have any tricks? Not that you're going to give away what you're going to try to do here, but do you have anything you'd like to set up on the power play?
Well, our power play is usually just give it to Petey for the one-timer, but who knows? I guess we'll have to find out and see. I guess we'll find out. See if Petey's out there right now. Yeah, there he is on the back right. Sounds pretty good. One-timer?
There's Ben with a one-timer from the line. Ben Bishop with a nice save there.
I tried to move it.
I got to say, you're probably in a bit of a good spot here considering Tyler cannot win a face-off, so we could be looking at back-to-back-to-back one-timers from the point here.
Probably.
There it goes again.
Nice another good hit in front.
Oh, no. Get that thing.
And you have to regroup here in the neutral zone, will Jake Virtanen. For Bo Horvat on the left wing.
Come on, Riggy.
Pass in front, one-time chance, and another good save.
Oops.
And another turnover, chance for an odd man rush. Can Jake double his lead here as he sets up in the zone, walking out front, trying to pass to the point with a shooting chance right in the slot. And now Tyler's able to kill some time in the neutral zone. Power play winding down here, first period winding down as well. Backhand shot for the high slot. Ben Bishop with the save and a big collision in front of the net there. The power play is over, and so is the first period.
Come on.
1-0 for Jake Virtanen after one. How are you guys feeling after that first period?
Pretty average.
Start with you, Jake.
I mean, I feel like we do a little bit better, but Tom didn't have his controls figured out, so I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt. I think he's better.
How about you, Tyler? We're seeing lots of replays of Ben Bishop making some great saves there, holding you in it to this point.
I'm down one goal, so I feel absolutely phenomenal right now. I feel like I've won already.
Yeah, that's really good.
Do you feel like the controller settings were the reason that you got scored on in the first 30 seconds? Or was that going to happen regardless of the setup? Tough to say, really.
Tough to say. Good goal.
Oh. Come on.
As we're back underway in the second period, and good shooting chance from the high slot. Maybe some momentum here. Well, we got a penalty and another Canuck power play.
Here we go.
Jake Virtanen with a chance to get that one-timer from the point from Elias Pettersson again.
Where are these refs from?
But you got yourself at the left point there, Jake.
Oh, that's weird. All right.
And here's Virtanen into the slot with a shot right on. Bishop makes the save, and he'll hold for the whistle.
We should get our own guys one breakaway each.
Ooh,
for sure.
I like that.
When you go away.
Is there a panic button?
That's what I'm doing in the face off.
Oh,
bitch.
Offside there is. Puck was cleared out of the zone. And still a very tight game here. Second power play of the game for Jake Virtanen with a 1-0 lead.
You got a face-off stat on you right now?
I don't. We could check in the intermission as Brock Besser drives the net, and another good save by Ben
Bishop.
See
that more from Brock. See that more from Brock.
What, driving the net?
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh, come on.
I just no idea what I'm doing. Holy. Back door!
Now a chance in front, one-timer. Good save. Adam Gaudette wide open in the slot there. Now Besser driving the net again, and he got crunched in the slot, lost the puck. And that allows Tyler Seguin to clear it all the way down the ice again. Only goal of the game came in the first minute.
No.
And the Canucks go offside there. How are you doing there, Tyler?
Dallas Stars hockey, baby. Play defense, kill, get penalties, wait for opportunity. Win 2-1.
As Jake continues to ramp up the pressure here.
Move it, Rube. Yeah. Spin. No.
And there's another.
The stick handle is the right joystick, right?
Yeah. Oh, here we go.
Slide, Johnson.
Tyler Toffoli down the right way. Pass in front. And a one-time tap-in chance goes wide. Pass picked off in the slot.
Let him go.
But a good defensive play to knock the puck away from Tyler Seguin there. Jake Virtanen with the Canucks back it over the line. One-timer off the post. Rebound in front. And Pettersson just couldn't settle it. Now Toffoli with a shooting chance through the middle. That was blocked.
Oh, no.
And the Stars come back, 2-on-1 chance, pass in front, and a great shot block there. Because I think Quinn Hughes got down in front of that one.
Quinn Hughes.
Laying out there.
Big saves from both goaltenders here in the second period. I think both of these guys have had two or three good one-timer opportunities. Unfortunately, not able to get it to go right now, though. Still a 1-0 game here for Jake.
Oh, let's pass again.
Oh God.
Some physical play there. Tyler does a good job standing up all of Jake's players at the attacking blue line. Here's Hughes in front, and he fires wide on the stick side of the goaltender, Ben Bishop. Now a turnover, chance for an automatic rush. There's Beagles knocked into the sideboards there, and back comes Stars. Got to get on side here.
Oh, cluster.
This is a cluster.
Lots of turnovers for both teams in the neutral zone, and offside again into the second half of the second period. Still 1-0, and I'll be on a pretty even game for the most part. Both of you guys have had chances here in the second period.
Both of them started a little bit nervous. I think now they're kind of, it's a bit of a feeling out process. They're learning each other's tendencies, learning how to play defense. And Jake has nicked another one off the post. That's two off the post this game already. How about another shot?
Oh, baby.
Couple of good looks. You have to think that Jake will get another goal if he continues to create those chances. And we've got a third power play tripping call there. How do you feel about the officiating here, Tyler?
He's gotten from Canada or something. I can say that.
Jake, back to the power play.
Just want one draw. If I win one face off, I'm going to be so happy.
Tyler Myers down the right wing into the slot. Another good chance, and I think it just tipped off the defender there. Went wide of the net. And tried to clear the zone. Rattanen with some good work along the boards to hold in, but now the Stars get it all the way down.
Second buzz.
Rattanen pass in front, broken up.
Just going in the net and slide.
And now Bo Horvat pass in front. One timer. And
5-on-3.
Another penalty here. 5-on-3. Short one, only 7 seconds. But maybe enough time to create one chance here, Jake.
Tyler just taking out his legs in front of the net, right in front of the crease. Unbelievable. Absolutely hate to see that.
Is a chance to create an opportunity, and the slot pass is picked off. We're back to a 5-on-4, and a shorthanded chance maybe here for Tyler, but he's crunched at the blue line. And now here's Jake back the other way. Pass in front.
Penalty again.
And another penalty. That might be a good penalty to take though there, Tyler, because
it
was going to be a tap in at the back door.
It's a really good penalty.
Just slide past him, guys. All right, Faxi, one time.
So plenty of time here with lots of room for Jake Vertanen, 5-on-3. Trying to find those passes through the slot. Another one's picked off there. Just trying to kill as much time as you can there with the puck, Tyler.
Yeah, pretty much. I don't know. I'm not on 5-on-3 as much. I'm not sure what to do.
As that goes wide of the net for the high slot.
No way. No, this is insane.
Another one.
Another one. 5-on-3. 42 seconds this time.
I'm due. Five on two for a goal.
Every time he touches the poke check button, a penalty is drawn. Another one. We're 5-on-3. We got to get one here, Jake. Let's win this draw and get a goal. Nice, quick shot.
That's what R1 means.
Oh, big block. Come on. Let's go. Yee.
Puck all the way down. I'm assuming Murphy, you don't like to make your penalty kill work this much when you're playing, Tyler.
No. Not really.
Yeah, definitely not.
I mean, I kill penalties, but not 5-on-3, but this would be exhausting.
One-time chance again.
See, that's what's got it.
Oh my god, what a slide.
And I will say Tyler's doing a great job of getting guys down in front of the net. Huge save there by Ben Bishop on the tap-in chance. As Jake amps up the pressure here, still on the power play. And yet it's still a 1-0 game. Final minute of the second, maybe hands for Tyler to tie the game. Can't get it to go. There was Jamie Benn there waiting for the rebound. Maybe one last chance for Jake, dying seconds of the period. Another save for Bishop, and it's still 1-0 through 40 minutes. The penalty kill for Tyler Seguin coming up huge in that second period.
Right where I want him.
I was going to say, you can trip the guy for, you know, taking, I think he's had, what, 5 penalties now, but he hasn't gotten scored on one of them. So as long as it works,
he's got a good PK, I'll tell you that.
Where's the 19-6 shots.
All right.
Where's the face-off? Face-off's 18-1.
Oh, you got one of them? I didn't even see that.
Not one. Must have been an accident.
I was going to say, I don't remember that one.
There's an accent.
I remember it.
So we go to the third period here, still a 1-0 hockey game. And all it takes is one chance for Tyler Seguin to get back into this game, tie it up. Here on the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. And it's Jake Virtanen amping up the pressure early. But now maybe an opportunity.
Oh.
Tyler Seguin into the slot. Would have been a 2-on-0 maybe right in on net. The puck was knocked loose. Good shot block there.
Oh, nice pass. Oh, see you.
Should mention again, if you want to contribute to the charitable portion of this stream, raising money for frontline workers through Canada Helps, you can donate by clicking on the link below the stream or go to canadahelps.org for more information on how you can help. Jake still buzzing in the offensive zone.
No. Power play.
And another power
another
play
penalty.
Here.
I truthfully didn't even see where this one happened. I have no idea. Could be anywhere. Your guess is as good as mine. Look like right in front again. He's doing the dive in front, just taking out the legs every single time.
It's like a chop block to the knees there.
He's going back door. He can take it away.
Yep, whatever works.
Well, it's clearly not working.
Oh, come on.
Nice play there by Tyler to knock the puck free. And he'll get it out of zone.
Oh,
Jake trying to drive back in. Tyler Myers on a breakaway to the forehand. And a good save there again by Ben Bishop.
I'm just glad I didn't get a penalty.
Yeah. How about Ben Bishop so far in this game? The saves that he's had, the bailouts here, it's just unreal.
Oh.
Not quite as much work for Jacob Markstrom at the other end, but still a one-goal hockey game. As Tyler clears it down on the PK.
I wasn't trying to clear it. I'm trying to pass all those. They just go deep.
When you're on the PK, I guess it a happy accident works out anyway.
Yeah. Got more dump-ins in this game than my career.
Boom.
More hits too, actually.
That's... Oh no. There's
an icing.
And that's an icing. So offensive zone faceoff here for Tyler Seguin.
Well, it's game gonna win it.
Hey, this could be your second
one
of the game.
Game.
Yeah, let's get one more right now.
Can't strike twice.
No. First thing I'm doing after this game is going to look up how to win it off.
Oh, boy.
Let's go.
Turnover at center off the big hit there, but Jake doing a good job getting the puck back at his own blue line. And now a chance in on the right wing. Pass in front, it's 2-0. Nice cross-crease pass yet again, and Jake Virtanen doubles his lead here in the third period.
And I think that's going to be the only way that he can really solve Ben Bishop, those wide open cross crease feeds. Unfortunately, Tyler was not able to take out the legs of the guy in front of the net in time, and that one finds the back of the net. He actually tried to. You could see him dive in there. He was about a second away from making it happen.
It was right there.
Oh, that was funny.
And so it's 2-0 now. Still half a period left.
It's like the draws are ridiculous.
And here is Jake Virtanen trying to build on that 2-0 lead. A goal in the first 30 seconds of the game, and puck goes down the ice again, Tyler.
All right.
I'm trying to pass it. Oh, wait. How do you do that?
We have a scrap coming here, maybe.
I was trying to do it.
Hey!
Oh, there it is!
Face Let's off,
we need a celebration.
For Tyler Seguin. Second face off win of the game.
It's a goal in my book. The only problem is I don't know what I did.
Two goals for Jake, two face off wins for Tyler. Tied hockey game?
Oh, again!
And yet another icing call off an attempted pass.
I'm looking for a goalie.
How are you feeling here, Tyler? You got a comeback in you?
Hold on, I'm trying to fight right now. How do you... Plus.
Uh-oh.
Oh, here we go.
How
do we do it? How do we do it?
JT Miller and Blake Como drop in the mitts. A lot of jockeying right now. And here they come together.
How do you punch?
Right hand free for both. Neither landing a shot here. There's Jake around with the right hand and the uppercut, too. Short little left hand.
Oh!
Come on, Chris.
And a big shot with the right.
There's
a couple of good shots from Sagan with the right hand. Both just wailing away here. And down goes JT Miller.
Millsy,
a big fight win
one.
For Tyler Sagan.
My second career fight, thanks.
Blake Como, JT Miller, who would win in that fight in real life?
Definitely not Millsy.
Yeah, Como's pretty tough. I'm not sure about Miller. And face up loss.
Another save by That's Ben cool. Bishop. Chance in front, one God. Timer, and Bishop with a good left pad save again.
Oh.
And there's a glove hand save too. Ben Bishop might be the MVP of this game, regardless of what happens.
Standard. Oh, nice one there. That's what we pick. And another almost ice.
And now the question will remain, does the score stay 2-0? Did Tyler Sagan break the goalless bid for Jake Virtanen, or can Jake be on the lead here? Running out of time late in the third period.
Oh,
come on, Uzi.
Pass into the slot, picked off again. Good active stick from Tyler Sagan's defenseman there in front. And he dumps the puck in again.
Yeah, I'm trying to pass it, boys.
Oh, here we go.
Now here's Jake Virtanen, controlling Jake Virtanen, going to the net. Turned the corner, but Ben Bishop was there to make the save at the post again. Final minute here, how are you guys feeling?
I'm looking for another goal here, but... Bishop's having a night.
I'm looking for a shot.
Chance up the ice. Good play in front of the net. As Tyler was going for the cross-crease pass there. Now a chance in alone. Oh, that just missed the net. Jacob Markstrom came charging out to the circle there. And... Jake looking to run out the clock here a little bit, I think. 20 minutes left.
One last penalty for good measure for Tyler. Just got to end the game on a note that kind of sums up the entirety of this game. An ice and another trip.
Oh.
And there it is.
Nice call, ref.
So I don't even know. What is this, the 8th or 9th power play of the game for... Jake Virtanen here, dying seconds. As time will run out, and Jake Virtanen will move on to the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge final presented by the Gaming Stadium. Now let's start with you, Jake. Just your thoughts on a nice 2-0 win there.
Oh, well, I got to give him a 1-0. I'll take the 1-0 win because his controller wasn't his controls weren't right, but it is what it is. I'm happy with the win. I guess we'll find out what happens next game.
How about you, Tyler? A lot of penalties there. You had a couple of good chances. You won a couple of draws.
Yep.
How are you feeling?
Lots of penalties, costly mistakes, no face-off wins, and the star players on the Dallas Stars just didn't show up tonight. I don't know what they were doing there in Vancouver, but they didn't show up tonight, and that was it.
Ben Bishop, second star.
28-6 in shots.
Look at the face-offs. What was the final 32. On the what was the final on the face-offs?
27-2.
Oh my gosh.
Time on attack.
Time on
30-50 to win. I had a great time though.
Yeah, that was all right, really Tyler,
appreciate you guys coming on.
Thanks for playing. No problem, appreciate it. And Jake, we'll chat with you in a little bit here when you move on to the final to face either Pierre-Luc Dubois or Thomas Chabot. That matchup coming up next. And I don't know if you are familiar with either of these guys, Nasher, in terms of their ability to play the game, but you know, what sort of challenge could we see in the second game here, do you think?
I think it's going to be a good matchup. Both of these guys, from what I've heard, are gamers. Pierre-Luc Dubois, more of a FIFA guy, from what I've heard. But I did go to the NHL 20 launch event with him. Saw him play a little bit. He does have some skills. So I'm not saying that first matchup was bad by any means. But I'm hoping for some, you know, some more action, maybe some more goals, a bit of a closer game here in game number two.
We'll be back in just a moment with the second of three games here. Thomas Chabot against Pierre-Luc Dubois at the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge. Back in a moment.
Is able to get one ahead for Tyler Seguin with 33 goals and 80 points last season.
Oh my God,
what a play that was.
Have a 2-0 league, and Tyler Seguin, who's one of the most talented offensive players in this game, makes a beautiful move on Larkin.
Garnett works his way back to the blue line, leaves for Ben. Jordy Ben with a wrist shot blocked, and now he's got to hustle back. Four stars to center. Seguin leading the way on the left wing. Drop pass, Pavelski across, Seguin scores! It came off Haskinen and right to him. And Tyler Seguin had a tap in to make it 3-2 Dallas.
Get that shot through and now you're scrambling. Everybody's scrambling. Haskinen reads this play very well. He jumps up. I don't think he meant that to be.
Bird rolling up the boards. Tyler Seguin is there for it. Mete is back. Seguin waits. Backhander scores!
That fool's carry, but you got to respect the shot, first of all, from Seguin, because he could score from that right-hand position.
Michael Ferland. Ferland moving in on Gudas. Throws on the brakes. Passes back. Bo Horvat centers the puck for Cannon. Scores! It's happy hour.
Vertanen gets it forward for Zach McEwen. McEwen to the middle. Vertanen is in, trying to tuck it home. He scores! On deck for Vancouver, getting a pass through, and a goal by Vertanen. And just like that, the Canucks
keeps it down low. The pass was in behind Antoine Roussel as Vancouver's changed up its personnel. Myers walks in, here's a shot, scores!
So Canucks are on the board, shots are now 9-1. And here's a turnover and a chance for Tannen. Stuffed by Quick. Rebound scores.
The Hurricanes' Joel Edmondson. Now Brock McGinn for Edmondson. Broken up by Nyquist. He tries to spring Dubois. Pierre-Luc Dubois is in. He scores!
Left hand to help out on the separation. I mean, back in the second period, that could have been called a hold. And he is able to ward off McGinn and make a power move with it.
Dubois trying to work a give and go. He's going to get there. Open net against Leonard, and he poked it home. Pierre-Luc Dubois.
Dubois got inside position on Connor Murphy. And then he helped himself out. He kind of slingshot himself, partner.
Dubois, headman's at puck to Nyquist. Nyquist springs down. Dubois scores! Jackets win it overtime.
With authority, right over the shoulder. It's a give and go. Dubois, Nyquist, Dubois.
Back the other way. Brown with a wrist shot. Jay Fleury up high. Rebound to Tierney. He'll feed it out high. Shabbat curled and drives and scores! What a move by Thomas Shabbat. Cut his way to the middle and goes upstairs on Marc-Andre Fleury.
What a chance at the other end. First for Pacioretty, but the little glimpse into the talent that Thomas Shabbat has. Watch a little toe drag around Stastny. Curl, drag, release, top corner. It's a beautiful goal by the defenseman of Ottawa.
Well, it continues as the Sens come back up the ice. Here's Shabbat, straight up the middle. Shabbat scores! What a goal, Thomas Shabbat!
And he's going to go right through the Boston defense corps right there and goes top shelf on Rask. And what I like about this is his patience. He sees Carlo coming. He recognizes Carlo's got a long reach, so he lays the...
What a slick play by Brown, and it nearly results in the equalizer. Scores! Thomas Shabbat got the equalizer! When Severson can't clear it, goes right up the middle.
Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. Brendan Batchelor alongside Nasher getting set for our second game here coming up. Jake Virtanen victorious in the first semifinal. He beats Tyler Seguin 2-0. And just your overall thoughts on Jake Virtanen's win. I know Tyler struggled with his controls off the hop there, Nasher, but Jake Virtanen's moving on.
Yeah, big credit to Jake. He showed up in the big game, scored, you know, in the first 30 seconds there. Controller settings messed up or not, that is very impressive that he was able to do that. Overall, I think he controlled the game, shot a lot of pucks on net. Wasn't able to really beat Ben Bishop, who, fortunately enough, he's not going to have to play against in the next matchup. So, expecting big things here from Jake.
So, we'll move on to the next game coming up here in just a moment, as we're joined now by Thomas Shabbat of the Ottawa Senators and Pierre-Luc Dubois of the Columbus Blue Jackets. Good afternoon, guys. How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
We're good.
Good. Let's start with the UTMS, what's your level of confidence going into this game? Do you play NHL a lot? We saw Tyler in the first game, hadn't played a whole lot, and he struggled. Where would you rank yourself in terms of an NHL gamer?
I think I play a little bit of it. I'm not of I think I spend more time playing other games, but I've played a bit growing up, and obviously I've played pretty much every NHL growing up. So I'm decent, but I think it should be a fun matchup. It's for a great cause, and we should have lots of fun.
How about you, Pierre-Luc?
I played a lot when I was a kid. I still play hybrid controls, so that says a lot about my game. Nash has seen me play before. I know how to do limited things, but I think my puck movement's good enough, so hopefully that can carry me through the game.
And Thomas, you brought up the charitable aspect as well. Great that we could be helping out frontline workers through Canada Helps today. If you're watching, you can click the link at the bottom of the stream to donate or go to canadahelps.org. And I'm sure both of you guys are excited to be part of this because of that charitable element.
Of course.
Oh yeah, for sure. I think it makes the whole thing definitely better, and it's always fun. Obviously, PLD and I are good buddies, and it's good to just match up each other. We're known doing a couple of times that in QMJHL and all that, so it's gonna be fun.
Well, I think we can get to the game then if you guys are both ready to go, and we'll have the Columbus Blue Jackets against the Ottawa Senators here after Jake Virtanen's Vancouver Canucks advanced to the final in the first game, beating Tyler Seguin by a score of 2-0. And once we get rolling here, we can chat through this game as well. Not a great start, just like we had in the other game.
Just on that screen, scroll down. You have to scroll down once and then hit X, I think, before the jersey select. Like hit X here.
Okay.
And then scroll. Like X here? And hit X. Yep. And hit X one more time. And then scroll down and hit X.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. There you go. We got her.
Right. Yeah, this is not a great look for you right here, I'll be honest.
Yeah, but see, like, that's a tactic.
Getting into his head a little bit. Have you guys ever played against each other? You said you're good buddies. You played against each other at all or no? First time?
First time playing each other.
We talked last night.
Okay.
We prepped last night.
Now, when we talked to both Jake Virtanen,
Doobie got a couple games in.
Yeah.
Oh, did he? You got a little warm up. Okay.
Yeah, I got a warm up last night. I'm not going to lie.
How'd you do in the warm up?
I lost both games to my friend who doesn't play either, so I'm kind of nervous.
Same story as our first game where Jake Virtanen and Tyler Seguin both lost against the computer last night. So we'll see how things go here. Pierre-Luc Dubois control of the puck early on.
Ooh.
Trying to make nice deke off the right wing. Puck is knocked loose. Back come the Senators. Centering pass attempted there, but it was blocked wide to the corner.
Guy says he doesn't play zones, saucer passes around.
Yeah, this guy's already pulled off two toe drags and two saucer passes,
like,
and we're 3 into the game. No, it's...
And he's trying to tell us he's not playing.
I said I used to play.
Trying to lull the competition into a false sense of security there on the game menu before the game. Hey,
that's a trip. 100% power play.
Classic Duval right there.
Power play coming up when Columbus touches the puck, but maybe a chance for Thomas Chabot before that.
Keep
puck in the attacking zone and be forced back to center.
You want to skate all over the zone?
No, I was waiting. Everybody was offside.
And now we'll get the penalty.
Tio.
Wow, he gets the penalty with himself in the game, too. You just hate to see that. PLD going to the box with
Spark
PLD.
The
Spark the boys with a big chip.
We've seen that before.
Oh, turnover.
Chance in front, fired over the goal.
Come on,
good power play look there for Thomas Chabot. as the puck is dumped in. Still plenty of time here on the power play for Thomas Chabot to try and answer back, but it's...
It's iced there on the power play.
That's a new power play breakout. Just dump it in.
Win the face-off and you're back to square one. It's the same thing.
That's a trip. 5-on-3.
So we can't see your gameplay right now, so you guys will have to kind of take the commentary role if you don't mind. Was that a trip on PLD again?
Yeah, I just got another power play. David Savard.
So 5-on-3 here? Okay.
Yeah.
5-on-3. I'm skating out of the zone. Just toe-drag this first guy. Oh, I'm gonna... No. You know what? Gotta fight another day. No.
Okay, where are you going?
Chabby's coming.
Oh,
so, as we take break here, how are you guys feeling early on? A couple of penalties for you, PLD, but overall still confident?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I'm not going to lie. I'm not great, but Chabby doesn't seem really good either, so I'm pretty confident. I don't know what it's going to be like, but I think it's pretty good.
There's not a lot of shooting, that's all I know. Oh,
and
man,
I just scored my goal. Toe drag.
Oh.
Okay,
you gotta describe it for
we
us.
We can't see it.
Because we can't see it.
Yeah, so what was it? Toe drag 5-on-3 you scored?
Undescribable.
Undescribable.
2-on-1. 2-1. Toe drag. Bring it to my backhand. Slip it back door to Atkinson.
Wow. What a banger. All right, so
1-0
for DeBall on a shorty.
Was it shorthanded? I don't know. I stopped counting my penalties. It's going to be a long game.
I think it might have been but back 5-5.
Oh, it was?
What a play by Wenberg. My boy, Wenberg.
So how are you feeling, Thomas? Down 1-0 early. Are you still confident you can battle back in this one?
Yeah, you know what? That's what happens. I was 5-on-3, didn't take advantage of my chance. So he goes down the ice and buries on that 2-on-1. So that's the way hockey is. But no, I think I've been all over him since the start of the game. Should be an interesting ending of the first period.
What do you agree with that, Pierre Luke?
he had two power plays. He didn't even enter my zone once. He took two slap shots from the blue line. He's got a weak shot.
Yeah, but
so,
penalties fly by.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, the penalties do go quick. And it's looking like you're going to be in more penalty trouble throughout the game too. So, who's to say?
No, I'm not poking the puck away anymore. I'm going to have the puck the entire game. There
we go. So it sounds like we're back underway, but we can't. It's happening. So you guys are going to have to do the play-by-play for us here.
I just got another good
obviously,
chance.
I
got
I have
another
the puck again,
oh, no.
And I'm going on the power play again.
Oh my! I thought you were gonna stop poke-checking.
I did. Anderson hit a guy from behind the corner. I mean, we're sending a message early on, so it's fine.
So it stops poke-checking and goes for the hits from behind instead.
Oh
yeah. I mean,
so it was on the peak. If
the
I
coach was... is the coach is okay with that.
And here we are back in business. 1-0 game for Pierre-Luc Dubois on a goal that sounded amazing, but we didn't see it, so we'll have to take his word for
it.
Truthfully indescribable, as he would put it. Uh-oh.
And yeah, maybe a chance to 2-0. Shooting through the middle. Yeah, we can see now. We're good. And here's a 2-on-1. Pass in front. What a save, kicking out the left pad.
Nice save, Corpy.
You know, it's Corpusalo. Here's Pierre-Luc Dubois back the other way. Chance in front.
Oh my God! Turnover.
My D's aren't too. D's aren't too scared.
And here's Chabot in alone. Couldn't get the shot away. Pass back in front, and he scores. Tied hockey game 1-1. Off the second opportunity.
All over him.
Greasy goal.
We call that one indescribable there? No, was that greasy?
No, that's greasy.
No,
that's
it's just
hey, it was a goal though. No, I like that goal. He had a little breakaway, turned around in the corner and went for a low pad rebound instead. That's a good hockey play.
Hey, that's
nice little Selly there afterwards.
I give it back to him.
So we have a goal each way, which is what something we can't say for the first game.
Ooh.
And this maybe a little bit more drama to come in this one.
Join the rush. Oh no!
Clapper from the circle goes wide of the net.
What are you doing?
I wanted to go far pad.
Are you serious? That, you did not. You tried to go far pad on purpose in NHL.
I swear to God.
You ever play video games? Alright.
See how, like, this is not even fair for Gibby. Like, I'm all over him. Stop. Oh,
I'm scared.
Get beat to the
nose.
Yeah. Power play again.
Oh. There's a tripping penalty.
I can't poke-check anymore. I can't get the puck.
Shabbat with another golden opportunity. These power plays are going to be his chance to really shine here. 2 minutes left in the period. Bound to get a quick one here. Let's see if he throws some more shots on that.
Shot for the point there, but maybe a shorthanded chance. Pierre-Luc Dubois. Room on the right wing, but couldn't get the pass through in front of the net. And now a three on one for Shabbat.
Oh my God.
Tried to drop it back to the point. And instead,
I'm gonna go ahead and say it's not what he intended to do on that play. No. Had two guys wide open back door, throws it up to the point on accident. But a break the other way.
Okay.
Maybe an opportunity for redemption.
Here. Get back up.
Dying
shots.
Seconds of the power play, last
control.
And first.
Oh yeah, what a
and
goal.
And a shot for the point, it's
what
tipped in front. Power
wow,
play goal.
What a play.
Okay.
Fires Chavi. It low on the net. PLD was tripping and pursuing low, shooting for rebounds. Gets the tip right in front. And now he is up 2-1. The penalty trouble for PLD really costing him.
Yeah, it's like that in real life too. Sometimes. Gotta get...
Oh, that's another grab.
Another one.
I'm not even gonna try to poke check anymore.
And so the second period will start with a power play as Thomas Chabot takes a 2-1 lead into the first intermission. And let's start with you, Thomas, battling back after giving up the first goal. You got to feel pretty good.
No, feeling good right now. Good first period. Obviously, wish I buried more on the power play, but it's good to get a late one here. What a nice tip from Brady in front of the net on the power play. It's the way the game's been going. I've been controlling the game pretty much for a while. So, no, I'm just kidding. But no, it's been good for the sense.
And for Pierre-Luc Dubois, the penalty trouble coming through to cost you to this point a little bit.
Yeah, 8 penalty minutes. I know if I know Torts, I know he'd be pissed off right now. The boys are getting. No more poke checks in the second and third period, so hopefully we can stay out of the penalty box.
Let's get to the second period here.
Yeah, go ahead and set it up.
The fans are loving it too, so you got to give them what they want.
And the power play to start for Thomas Bott here in the second period.
Oh, yeah,
here on
sure.
The Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. Thanks for joining us, whether you're watching on Twitch or on Jinx TV. And again, we remind you, raising money for frontline workers through Canada Helps. Click the link below the stream or go to CanadaHelps.org to donate and for more information. Thomas Chabot going to work on the power play here.
Seen pass.
One timer off the nicely executed power play setup. The umbrella there. Shorthanded break for Pierre-Luc Dubois. Puck comes back the other way. Drop pass. Room in the slot. Oh, and a nice kick save by Jonas Korpisalo.
Oh, no.
Winner of this game will move on to face Jake Vertanen of Vancouver Canucks in the final. Bring to you here in a few minutes. But still lots to play for in this game. And really back and forth here. Both guys getting good looks. You have to feel, even though it's 2-1, that it still could be anyone's game at this point.
Yeah, and you can really kind of see the difference in their play style. I think Shabbat's more of a, you know, a true hockey player when it comes to NHL. He's firing pucks low, working the point. You see PLDs on the PK, doing two drags up the ice as he gets across the blue line, playing a little more arcadey and trying to get fancy with it. So interesting to see how these two different styles clash here.
Oh, rebound chance there of John for the half wall.
The far pass is working goal, for rebound.
If you score another goal, far pass. Here we go.
Partial breakaway and the puck is dumped in. Opportunity goes by the wayside for Pierre-Luc Dubois.
Good poke check. Good.
All the way here. Shabbat hit a load. And couldn't get it to go.
The trip.
What a poke check from behind check from there. PLD there. Yeah, you know, with the penalty troubles he's been having, I'm surprised he was able to get that one pulled off nice and clean. Yeah. Cuts off the breakaway and keeping this game within one here.
I was extremely nervous.
Second period, here's another chance for Shabbat.
Oh, no, I wanted to go far.
Clapper from the half wall. Stopped by Korpisalo.
Nice pass.
How big of a grind is my NHL game? Taking clappers from the corner.
They're creating rebounds, though.
Okay. I got to shoot.
Oh, yeah, that's the whole point of it.
Don't even try to score. Just shoot it off the pad.
Short side.
Chance again on the wing. Trying to go short side shelf. Korpisalo got the shoulder on it.
Jeez, look at that puck.
Another turnover in the neutral zone.
Ooh. That's a
big
two,
hit on
100%.
The board.
Might be a game.
2 minutes. And a big opportunity on the power play here for Pierre-Luc Dubois to tie the game.
The power play has been the difference maker so far in this game.
Or excuse me, it's Shabbat to the power play. Chance to extend the lead.
Umbrella set up. Umbrella. Oh no.
Oh no. Oh, turnover. It's a breakaway from his own blue line. In. And it's stopped by Anderson. Nice little deke to the forehand there. And now a 3-on-2 the other way on the power play. He'll just set up in the zone with a nice one-timer from the line. And that goes wide.
Oh, no.
Let's go. Far pad.
Now another opportunity at the left wing with a long shot. Working out of the Thomas Shabbat playbook with the clapper.
That's a knee. Good.
Oh,
call.
No. Oh, no.
And another penalty.
We have a charging penalty.
Charging.
I don't even know where this
one
happened.
So it'll be a 5-on-3.
I think it was a little bit off screen. Yeah, as the puck goes away, he just runs him into the corner.
It's fine. It's shabby. It's good. It's worth it. It's a good penalty.
5-on-3 here. And a chance to make a big difference in the game, but a good... important face-off win for Pierre-Luc Dubois. He's going to carry it up the ice here, shorthanded. Back comes Shabbat, 2-on-1.
Oh, no.
Into the slot, made a move, lost the puck.
Then, I didn't mean to shoot that
long
one.
Shot
I
for the half court again.
Oh, no.
Here's a break for Pierre-Luc Dubois. Pass in front, looking for the one-timer, broken up on the back check. And the Senators. And Thomas Shabbat will come to center. 2 minutes left in the period.
Oh.
Pass in front and a good back check to break that up through the middle.
I'm not low checking anymore.
And an offsider. How are you feeling, Pierre-Luc? Couple of looks. You had a breakaway. Still confident you can get back in it here?
Yeah, but. The penalties are really hurting me, so no more poke checks from the Blue Jackets, so it's going to be a tough game.
No.
And he's back.
Chance in
well.
Front, but the pass broke it up. And now Dubois in across the attacking blue line.
Yeah,
trying to get a shot there, last few seconds of the period, blocked.
Oh no.
By Shabbat, he'll pass back to Craig Anderson and plays it to the corner. Ooh. Maybe one last opportunity as the puck rolled out in front. And we're through 40 minutes here. With a 2-1 lead for Thomas Shabbat. Heading
you
to
can
the
tell
third
it's starting
period.
To get a little bit more starting to get a little bit more competitive here. The guys are starting to quiet down a little bit. They're in their zone. You can see PLD obviously trying to change up his game plan a little bit. You're going to see a lot less poke checks, and hopefully that leads to more opportunities going the other way. What a game we have here, though. Nice close battle.
2-1 game.
Just for the record, Chabby's not playing his Ds. He's using his back checker. So he's not even defending. That's the computer doing the work.
Hey, you could do the same thing, you know? Both have the same equal opportunities right here.
See that? That was Ronnie. That was a D. Backdoor.
Shabbat pass in front. He scores. And it's 3-1. Pierre-Luc Dubois with his head in his hands.
What a feat across the middle. Makes his way through the blue line. Finds him backdoor. And I think that one snuck 5-hole on Corpy. Now we got a little battling back that we have to do here. Down 2 for PLD. Oh, and he poke checked already and got another penalty. Not what you like to see here.
I was like, I was thinking I got to risk it. I need the puck. I'll give it a poke check for the first time in the last 20 minutes. And that's what happens.
Right into the skates.
Right. It wasn't even close. And then Chavis passed the puck around for about a minute and a half. Just collapse, boys.
Yeah, this looks exactly like an NHL power play. Just working the puck around the outside, trying to find those openings.
I need a fight here or something. I need to get the boys going.
I need to change, put the different unit on.
You need to get 3-1. You need to get Chavy off the ice.
Yeah. I didn't put him on. See? Go back. Oh, my
Uh-oh.
God.
Oh, here's
again.
A turnover and another partial breakaway chance to make it a one-goal game. But a great defensive play on the back check there. Now a turnover again.
Where am I going?
Deking through the slot. Pierre-Luc Dubois loses the puck again. Now here's Shabbat in front looking for a one-time chance in the slot. Broke up. And a two-on-one again. Shooting chance right on. Korpisalo with the save. Dubois moves the puck quickly, trying to get up ice here. Still a fair amount of time left. But we'll need a goal sooner rather than later if wanting to battle back in this game. Odd man rush again. Shabbat breaking through. Man. Pass in front. And a nice save by Korpisalo. Big hit in the corner. Now a chance to walk right in front. No defenders in the area.
I know where. His D, he's shutting it. He's playing good D. I'm not gonna lie. He's shutting it down. He's clogging up the new zone.
Oh man, that's
a good poke
been nice.
Check there.
another
penalty.
And I get a
I believe we had another charging. He stopped poking, but now every single hit has been either an interference or a charge here in the last two periods. Another PK to get a quick kill here and make his way up the ice.
Oh, I saw a stat. I saw a stat earlier. 20,
nice glove save there.
5 of the hits.
Yeah, that's true. I saw that one too. Ooh.
And there's a huge check to break what would have been a partial breakaway. Maybe a chance to
what
tie it kind of the goal. Nice poke check to knock the puck free.
3-on-1.
Pass in front and a good right pad save. Off another great opportunity for Thomas Shabbat. Nice. And that'll be offside. Now we didn't get into it earlier, but you guys must go back quite a way. You played against each other in the queue, I would imagine.
Yeah, we played against each other in the queue. And then we played like Dewey and Bantam together against each other. He played come on, groups.
One time chance
I had to
and
concentrate.
There you go. Well, to guess the story, you make it a 3-2 hockey game. Maybe that's the secret. Just you got to talk chance. While you're playing.
Go yeah, down memory road.
Much thinking going on. Chav, how about you explain it, so I can concentrate. You explore.
No, yeah, we did play. Played in junior against each other. Then growing up in pretty much all, no, probably well, a couple of years we played against each other. Obviously, we were playing both for our hometown teams, but we've played against each other quite a bit.
And now in a tight battle here at the Shaw Hockey Challenge, the Shaw Hockey Online Challenge here, presented by the Gaming Stadium.
Come on.
Jake Virtanen's already in the final. Thomas Chabot with the lead now, trying to advance. And Pierre-Luc Dubois looking to battle back with 5 minutes left in the third period. And an icing call there.
5 minutes left.
Chabot's just getting great opportunities.
We got ourselves a game.
Yeah, Chabot's had so many good opportunities, like two-on-ones, three-on-ones the other way. Unfortunate for Dubois. He's had a couple breakaways this game as well, just not able to bury him. Those greasy goals are really what's going to be the difference maker here in this one.
Maybe a chance for an opportunity. Shot right on. The rebound loose there.
No,
unable to get at it. The puck is back at center.
Man, worked here.
I gotta start poke checking.
Risky proposition.
Oh, no.
I gotta
puck goes all the way down the ice.
I have no other choice.
Oh my god.
Keep it.
There's no way. There you go.
So an offensive zone faceoff here. 2 minutes left.
My guys are tired. Goalie. They're exhausted.
Could pull the goalie.
No, I don't know how to
leave the goalie in for now. Faceoff win. And a shot just wide for the high slot. He scores! Pierre-Luc Dubois battles back from a 3-1 deficit, and the game is tied at 3 in late stages.
There you go. Back to normal now.
What a goal that was, too. Shot went a little bit wide off the point, ended up bouncing off the end boards, and he's able to bury it there short side. Not a lot of space to work with, but got it into the back of the net, and we are now tied up here with just about a minute and a half remaining.
First face-off win of the game, too. Doesn't hurt.
So will we have overtime here? Back and forth game. Or will it end before that? Here's Dubois passing for Weber. No, he scores! Two goals in the last 2 minutes, and it's 4-3 for Pierre-Luc Dubois.
Not a chance.
Chabot just had a loss of words right now. Two quick goals, wins the faceoff to get the shot originally. Score, go back to another draw at center ice, and he makes his way up the ice and scores. What a play. In just under 30 seconds, the game has changed drastically. Now it's on Chabot to get one on the board quick.
It's been a roller coaster ride so far. Do we have another twist to the tail here? Instead
of penalty. Chabot with two penalties to 4 minutes. Things are falling apart here.
Sorry, we'll get a story here.
50 seconds left. Important face-off win. And now Chabot's got to get it up the ice. Turned it over at his own blue line. But recovers the puck and needs to get out to center. Here's Dubois back in. Moved through the slot, lost the puck. Gets it back. Onto the left wing. Tight angle shot. Stop. And now just 30.5 seconds remaining.
Oh, boys. This is it. 30 seconds to go.
Give it your all. There's no tomorrow. All right.
I got him.
Here's a chance. 2-0 to tie it. What a save!
Come on.
No way. There's what a stop. Way. The diving desperation save Corposalo. Wide open on the back door. Now, PLD, a trip on the other end as the puck was released. So we are going to be at 4-on-4 here for the last few seconds. What a save.
Oh, my God.
It was a good trip.
I thought for sure that was 4-4. Face-off win, quick shot.
Shot on net. Get a stick on it. Except that. Get a stick on it.
Pull the goalie. Pull the goalie, I dare you.
I don't think I can. No, I can't press start.
18 seconds left. Another big face-off win.
No. Oh, yeah.
Pass to the boards. Chance to cut in
front. Oh, no.
But it's broken up through the middle. He'll hold it in the zone. 10 seconds left. Oh, in front. God. A great save by Corpusalo. Good chance for Thomas Chabot. And now an offside with 6 seconds left. And are we going to have a scrap here? Oh, not quite. Right at the end.
Chabot with two golden opportunities here at the end of this period. Now 5 seconds left. He has to win this draw. Let's see what happens.
He gets it forward. One last chance in and a diving. That's going to be a penalty.
Penalty shot.
No, it's a penalty,
penalty shot. Oh my goodness.
All right,
a penalty shot for Anthony Duclair.
PLD is going to be controlling the goalie here, so he has to manually play goalie. In the shootout, penalty shot here. Let's see what happens. What moves does Chabot have up his sleeves?
It is Chabot. In a goal. No. Scores! Are you kidding me?
No.
And it's a tied hockey game in the dying seconds.
So close.
Unbelievable.
You cannot get a better game than this one. A penalty shot with 2.5 seconds left. Chabot goes a backhand forehand and buries it. And we are now going to an OT. What a game this has been.
Let's start with Thomas Chabot. Things weren't looking good at the end. You give up two quick goals. You're behind. What are the emotions right now after scoring on that penalty shot?
That one feels good, especially like Nash just said, that I missed two big chances on 2-on-1s late in the third, trailing by one. So pretty happy we tied that one with a penalty shot there at the end.
And we can get into the overtime here.
Hop right into it here. 4-4. This is a crazy game. You know, the first game was a little bit slow. The guys were kind of getting used to each other, and they only had a couple goals on the board. These guys, though, no quit from them. Come back with 2.5 seconds on the clock and do that. It's just unbelievable. So here we go with the overtime underway.
Are we going to see some poke checks here at the OT, Pierre-Luc?
No, not a chance. Even less now. You weren't before, even less now. But you're going to see a lot of cheating and a lot of... a lot of just going at guys and then get the puck back quick. Where am I going?
Oh no.
Oh god.
We got time. Dude, you're chirping me about my D. You're doing the exact same thing. Oh, back door. That's it.
There's a chance in front. And a great save there.
No.
Corpusalo coming up big. Can Chabot end another good chance in front, just tipped away.
Okay, you're good. You got time.
And now he'll retreat to center.
I poke check.
Line change there, but here they are. Come ahead.
There you go.
Still playing.
Oh, no.
4-on-4 here.
Where did...
No. Now a chance.
Jonesy went for a left wing.
Where
did 2-on-1?
Where did Jonesy go?
And now a chance the other way to end it here in overtime. Shoots right on. My. Stopped by Corpusalo. He'll play it free.
Worth noting, PLD still has a minute and 20 power play here from that 4-on-4. But
here's a shorthanded chance right in front. Kicked out with the lad. Gets it back. And another save.
Oh, no.
Jonas Corpusalo coming up big here.
Get out of your net.
But now a chance for Pierre-Luc Dubois, still working on the
I'm
power
on
play.
PK.
The boys don't know what to do.
Shot for the point, looking for a tip. Stopped. And then played loose.
Cleared all the way down
on the PK.
5-on-5 now. Oh, it's a 20-minute overtime.
Boys.
It looks like a continuous OT, yeah. Somebody's got to finish
We're playing until someone scores. Chance in front, one timer.
No.
Partially blocked, plays it right back out. Rebound. And held out of the net.
No.
Nervous moments here in sudden overtime. Now a nice deke into the slot. Pass in front, just wide of the net. What a move by Thomas Chabot. Now here's Dubois into the slot, looking to shoot it right on. Blocked to the corner.
Okay. Trip? No?
No, never.
Good chances either way.
What's going on?
And now a pass in front to the back door, almost snuck in. And some good looks at both ends of the ice. But still tight.
Both goalies coming in huge. Yeah, lots of good opportunities, lots of backdoor feeds. These guys are looking for the guaranteed goals. Any way that they can get it in, they will take it. We're going to see a lot of those cross crease attempts. None have gone in so far, but I can guarantee you one will be coming soon.
Now here's a 2-on-0 chance. Chabot in front. Great save by Corpusillo. Didn't get all the backhander there. He goes for the shot for the point. Big block there. Out into the neutral zone. Back come the Senators. Shot rebound there. Just went wide of the net. Chances all over the place.
It's so unconventional that it works. No.
Here's a chance. In alone on goal to the backhand. Stopped by Corpusillo again. Plays it free.
Chabot coming out with some dangles of his own here. Those drags, the little windmill that he's doing every single time seems to be working. Both of these guys pulling off some nice moves here in OT.
8 minutes left in the first overtime. Still 4-4 after a thrilling finish to the third period. But saw Thomas Chabot tie the game on a penalty shot with less than 5 seconds remaining. Now here it is in front. Man. Stopped by Corpusillo.
Turnover
of the slot. Kind of surprised we haven't seen any penalties here, Nasher. After all the charging and poke checking during the regulation time, but here's a chance in front. Score! Pierre-Luc Dubois wins in overtime, and he's moving on the final to face Jake Virtanen.
And there was the cross crease, a nice little rush, finds it back door, and we finally got one to go. There were so many desperation saves there in overtime. Fortunately enough, BLD was able to get that there. You see Chabot diving out just a second away from catching that puck on the back check, but he does not get it. What a game it was.
Let's start with you, Pierre-Luc. Obviously, not the way you wanted the third period to finish, but nice to get it in overtime, I'm sure.
Yeah, they don't ask how. They ask if you want or not. And today the boys got it done, and we're proud, and hopefully
we
can keep the momentum into the next game.
How about you, Thomas? Obviously a huge comeback for your team, and you just can't see it across the finish line at the end.
Yeah, I mean, PLD came back from 2 goals. I came back from 1 with 2 seconds left, so and at this point, you can't ask for much more. I think when I look at it, shots 42-18, I think it tells a lot in favor of the Sens. But hey, sometimes it's the way it goes. But no, we had a blast. We had a lot of fun.
Yeah, I just want to thank you guys for putting on the show for us there. I mean, having that be as crazy as it was, that's one of the most fun games of NHL I've seen in a long time. So appreciate you guys coming on and playing.
Thanks to you guys. Appreciate it.
There you go. So it's Pierre-Luc Dubois and Jake Virtanen in the final of the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge. And I don't know if it'll be possible for us to have a more dramatic game in the final, but I guess we'll find out.
That was wild. A penalty shot with 2.5 seconds left. You just can't write stuff like that. To have it be as close as it was, as big of a battle as it was, and with them being good buddies, I know there's going to be a rivalry to come there. I'm sure they're going to even go back at it after this, so fun stuff all around. We are head to break. Thank you guys for tuning in for the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge. We'll see you guys with championships soon.
his skate. The Stars able to get one ahead for Tyler Seguin with 33 goals and 80 points last season.
Oh my God,
what a play that was.
Have a 2-0 league, and Tyler Seguin, who's one of the most talented offensive players in this game, makes a beautiful move on Larkin.
Gaudette works his way back to the blue line, leaves for Ben. Jordy Ben with a wrist shot blocked, and now he's got to hustle back. Four Stars to center. Seguin leading the way on the left wing. Drop pass, Pavelski across. Seguin scores! It came off Haskinen right to him. And Tyler Seguin had a tap in to make it 3-2 Dallas.
Get that shot through, and now you're scrambling. Everybody's scrambling. Haskinen reads this play very well. He jumps up. I don't think he meant that to be.
Murd rolling up the boards. Tyler Seguin's here for it. Mete is back. Seguin waits. Backhander scores! That fool's carry. But you got to respect the shot, first of all, from Seguin, because he could score from that right-hand position.
Michael Ferland. Ferland moving in on Gudas. Throws on the brakes. Passes back. Bo Horvat centers the puck for Cannon. Scores! It's happy hour.
Vertanen gets it forward for Zach McEwen. McEwen to the middle. Vertanen is in, trying to tuck it home. He scores.
On deck for Vancouver. Getting a pass through and a goal by Vertanen. And just like that, the Canucks
keep it down low. The pass was in behind Antoine Roussel as Vancouver's changed up its personnel. Myers walks in. Here's a shot. Scores!
So Canucks are on the board. Shots are now 9-1. And here's a turnover and a chance. Vertanen stuffed by Quick. Rebound scores.
The Hurricanes, Joel Edmondson. Now Brock McGinn for Edmondson. Broken up by Nyquist. He tries to spring Dubois. Pierre-Luc Dubois is in. He scores!
Left hand to help out on the separation. I mean, back in the second period, that could have been called a hold. And he is able to ward off McGinn and make a power move with it.
Dubois, try to work a give and go. He's going to get there. Open net against Leonard, and he poked it home. Pierre-Luc Dubois.
Dubois got inside position on Connor Murphy. And then he helped himself out. He kind of slingshot himself, partner.
Dubois, headman's at puck to Nyquist. Nyquist brings down. Dubois scores! Jackets win it overtime.
With authority, right over the shoulder. It's a give and go. Dubois, Nyquist, Dubois.
Back the other way. Brown with a wrist shot. Jay Fleury up high. Rebound to Tierney. He'll feed it out high. Shabbat curled and drives and scores. What a move by Thomas Shabbat. Cut his way to the middle and goes upstairs on Marc-Andre Fleury.
What a chance at the other end. First for Pacioretty, but the little clips into the talent that Thomas Shabbat has. Watch a little toe drag around Stastny. Curl, drag, release. Top corner. It's a beautiful goal by the defenseman of Ottawa to tie.
Well, it continues as the send come back up the ice. Here's Shabbat. Straight up the middle. Shabbat scores! What a goal, Thomas Shabbat!
And he's going to go right through the Boston defense core right there and goes top shelf on Rask. And what I like about this is his patience. He sees Carlo coming. He recognizes Carlo's got a long reach, so he lays the...
What a slick play by Brown, and it nearly results in the equalizer. Scores! Thomas Shabbat got the equalizer!
When Severson can't clear it, goes right up the middle.
back to the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Museum. Brendan Batchelor alongside Nasher as we get set for final. Jake Virtanen, after a 2-0 win over Tyler Seguin, moves on. While Pierre-Luc Dubois will be going to the final after a thrilling, and that's an understatement, I think, overtime victory or bot.
Yeah, what a game that was. PLD obviously played a pretty good game all around, I think. Started to fall apart there with just seconds remaining. Shabbat came back, and PLD takes it in overtime. So I think if you compare the two games, PLD obviously had a bit of a tougher road here to get to the championship. Virtanen obviously played a good, solid game himself, but didn't have much of a challenge. So I think with these two going together, it's going to be a good matchup and should make for a very fun and exciting championship.
As we welcome in Pierre-Luc Dubois and Jake Virtanen now getting set for the championship game. Let's start with you, Jake. You said you were watching that last game between PLD and Thomas Chabot. So how are you feeling confidence-wise going into this one? No, I don't think we have Jake. So let's go to PLD first if we've got you riding high at victory.
Yeah, I'm still shaking. Hopefully the momentum's still on our side, and we can bring that energy into this game.
And while we try to get Jake going here, we can remind you as well that the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium, brought to you by Shaw, Red Bull, eGames, GameStop, and AccuSpike. And again, we'll mention the charitable aspect, raising money for frontline workers through Canada Helps. If you're watching on Twitch, you can click the link below the stream to donate, or for more information, you can go to canadahelps.org and find out how you can help. And so we'll go to the championship game. I'm not sure if we have Jake back on microphone yet or not. So we'll get the game underway while we try to get Jake back on. Scouting report here, Nasher, after watching the first two games, what are your thoughts going into this one?
I think both of these guys have very different play styles. PLD, yeah, we got you. PLD, obviously, I think he was all about just going in, trying to dangle two people and trying to bury on a breakaway. Virtanen there, I think more of kind of a simple hockey player. He's going to shoot pucks low, kind of similar to how Shabbat did. And I think we've seen success both ways, so... Either way you look at it, this is going to be a close one as we get right into this one and load up.
And so, Jake, now that we've got you on microphone, you said you were watching the game between PLD and Thomas Chabot. So how are you feeling confidence-wise going into this one?
Yeah, honestly, they both looked pretty good. I was all watching it with my buddy. I'm a little nervous to see what happens, but we'll find out what happens. I mean... I think I'm going to be a little bit greasy, and he's got the skill, so I guess we'll see what happens.
So here we go. The Canucks and the Blue Jackets. Jake Virtanen and Pierre-Luc Dubois. And the final of the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. Of course, we remind you, the winner of this game is going to face the World Community Event. Early work in the attacking zone for Jake Virtanen. Pass in front, he scores. Jake Virtanen for a second straight game scores in the first minute, and he's got the early lead.
Yeah, what is this? Back-to-back games, literally wins the faceoff, goes up the ice and score, and I don't think this time we can use the controller setting excuse there. That's just a lack of defense there from PLD. Nice goal there from Jake, and he takes a 1-0 lead early.
That's a bad shift. First line, Jackets, get the ball off the ice. I mean, it's embarrassing.
Yeah, anytime around, it's fine.
All right.
You guys weren't ready to go for the drop of the puck?
Nope. Rarely start in Columbus, so it shows right now. It's pretty good. I don't know who said he played defense.
Here's a chance in front. Try to tie the game. Pierre-Luc Dubois. Oh. Big physical play. Now he's got room in the slot. And it's fought off to the corner by the goaltender, Jacob Markstrom for Vancouver. Nice job by to break up the play there. And he's got room up ice. Passes on to the wing.
I did not like.
Pettersson.
I'll take care of that.
Back to the line, long shot, rebound there, but collected by the Blue Jackets. Turnover as Pierre-Luc Dubois That's tries correct. To exit the zone. And now he's ahead with a chance to shoot. Pass in front, and it's a 1-1 hockey game. Pierre-Luc Dubois scores with Pierre-Luc Dubois.
What a goal that was. A nice little spin. He entered the blue line. Buries it with himself on the back door. That's just a beautiful hockey play. Again, lots of one-timers. We're going to see those cross creases go in a lot during these games. Nice goal there. We are tied one. These guys are going to, it's going to be a high-scoring affair here, Cadet.
Quick start to the game for sure. As we remind you that you can visit thegamingstadium.com for more information on a variety of online esports tournaments taking place regularly, just like this one, the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge. 1-1 game here in the first period of our championship game on the NHL players side of this tournament, and a shooting chance there for Dubois, stopped by Jacob Markstrom.
Something we haven't seen this game.
How are you guys feeling early on?
I'm concentrating as much as I can. Trying to gauge his talent level here. I'm a little nervous, I'm not gonna lie.
No. Oh, what a muffin. Come on. Oh, that almost went in.
Puck goes to the crease. As this is a really back and forth game here, Nasher. Good chances at both ends of the ice.
There is.
I was just going to comment about how we haven't seen a penalty yet and how that was so surprising. But the poke checks have come back for PLD as he gets in penalty trouble already. Now Jake with a chance to get a 2-goal lead here early.
Here we go.
Oh, it's 1-1.
Oh, yeah, it is 1-1. My mistake. Chance to go up here. 2-1.
Off to the power play.
He's playing like Javi. Get the half.
Turn around to the outside.
Oh.
Turnover in the slot.
Oh, no.
Terrible now that play. Should be icing against Jake Virtanen here. Nearing the midway mark of the power play. Pretty close game thus far.
All right, Bo, snap it back. That one.
Chance to cut into the slot, pass in front. Shot was blocked. And still on the PK here, Pierre-Luc Dubois holding on to the puck. Carry to center.
What are you doing?
Trying to make a move on the right wing, keeps it. Back to the line, long shot, blocked in front, big rebound. Directed out to back to even strength now. Chance for the lead for Jake Virtanen. Shot from the right circle, tip wide of the net by Corpus Sal. Physical play being thrown around, couple big hits there. Couple of turnovers. And now an opportunity into the slot. Pass back. One timer and a good save. Seemingly all like you guys are pretty evenly matched.
Oh,
and there's a goal.
Greasy.
Jake Virtanen crashing the net down the left wing.
Greasy.
Greasy goal makes it 2-1.
Did I score my own net? Yeah, peaked it.
I think yeah, it went off the
guess we'll see.
Went off the edge of the stick there as you went into the block the pass. Almost had the cross crease. I think either way that was probably gonna find it to the back of the net, whether it's a cross crease or trickling in there. Now we have a 2-1 lead here for Jake.
So now Jake has a chance to build a multi-goal advantage if he can score. Well, Pierre Dubois will try to battle back and tie this game late in the first period. And another good chance for Virtanen in front. Stopped by Jonas Korpisalo. As it looked, the feeling out process is kind of carried forward here. And now you guys are getting into the game.
Yeah, he's better than Chavy.
I'm feeling all right now. He was a third period player, so I'm nervous for the third.
Yeah, I'm keeping it in right now. I don't want to show everything I got.
And indeed, we did see that huge back. In the second game.
Ooh, nice save by Markey.
Good save there on a chance from the circle. And dying seconds of the period. Maybe chance for one more opportunity. Couldn't get it on net. And Clapper goes wide into the corner to end the first period. Ton hockey game. And certainly anyone's game at this point, you have to think.
Yeah,
notice both of these guys have kind of quieted down a little bit. In the first games they played, you know, they were chirping each other, going back and forth. It seems like they're a little more in the zone now, a little bit more focused. I'm sure we're going to be in for a very exciting second and third period here.
And we could get right to the
second period.
Right
now. For my skill.
I have another period.
Might be that good, but.
you're not turning it on until the third year? Don't expect anything too big in the second period.
No, just keep it simple.
No poke checks until the third.
Give it to Petey if I can.
Long shot for the point, looking for inflection. It was stopped there. Pucks in deep, 110%. Get behind their D. Is that the game plan there, Jake?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, I'm trying to just get pucks in net. A lot of back doors. I mean, the back doors are pretty much automatic if you get them. So that's all I got, really.
There it is.
And power plays.
And there's a tripping penalty for Pierre-Luc Dubois, which
is.
I feel like a broken record, but Jake Virtanen goes to the power play.
That's all right.
I think we really need it.
Took about 16 penalties on me last game.
We really need an I'm not poking one more time counter here for PLD. I think he said that probably 10 times throughout this broadcast, and he's still getting poke check penalties.
You'll get one in the third period, probably, when I start to poke, because I got to get the puck back.
A
couple of good looks on the power play, but Jake Virtanen can't finish it off. 45 seconds left in the man advantage here in the final of the Shaw Online Hockey Chow presented by the Gaming Stadium.
There it is.
And we have another tripping penalty.
This is where I need to get one.
So what do we have here? I think 20 seconds of a 5-on-3. Yep.
Trick play. Guy coming out of the buffer. Breakaway.
That was me too.
Face-offs now 8-3 for Jake Virtanen, which begs the question, was Tyler Seguin that bad at face-offs, or is Jake Virtanen that good?
I don't know.
So he snaps it back
again. Except not good at shooting. Here we go.
Here's a chance. Waiting. Good job by PLD to take away the pass by just lying in the slot. And now a rebound, right circle, kicked out by Corpus. Oh, another chance in front. And another big save by the Columbus Miner.
Get it, Corpy.
Still a power play here for Jake Virtanen. And pass in front goes to the left wing wall. Now trying to feed it back into the slot instead.
Oh, sorry there.
Dubois back with the puck.
Here we go.
Okay.
Looking to split the defense. Crunched instead. And Jake Virtanen trying to toe drag, turn it over. It's a 2-on-0. Hit on goal. Deeks to the forehand, lost the puck, got it back, and it's held out. Another big hit. Turns into a chance for the goal. As we see Pierre-Luc Dubois battling back here with a couple of huge opportunities to try and tie this game. It remains 2-1. And now maybe an opportunity for Jake Virtanen. Other way. Good poke check. Not a penalty that time. There's a rebound in front, and they score. 3-1 for Jake Virtanen. Rebound to the bottom of the right circle.
What a goal. Nice little move right at the blue line. Ends up making a spin, shooting low pad like he does. He's sticking to his game plan. He has his game plan, and he is just going through with it. What a shot. Gets it low and finds that rebound.
I heard last game that Xavi was going low pad, so I thought I'd do it.
It worked. It was working.
And it seems to be working right now. 3-1.
That voice plugging.
Midway mark of the second period. And another chance up the ice. Nice job breaking up the pass in the slot. But again, Virtanen continues to come in waves in front. He scores again. 4-1 for Jake Virtanen.
That was a pretty goal there. Hit him with a toe drag. The defender went flying, and he found it backdoor. Let's look at this one more time. Couldn't get down into that block pass fast enough, and it goes right between his legs into the back of the net. Now, PLD has been down before. We said he was a third-period player. Will he show up again big in the third period here? We will find out.
That's asking a lot. That's asking a lot. First line's dash three tonight, so I don't know.
Still plenty of time left.
Yeah, last game I was pretty shocked that it came back, so we'll see.
Offside on the play there.
Offside.
Here in the final of our NHL player portion of the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. Jake Virtanen looking to build on a 4-1 lead with another cross-crease pass and a good glove save by Jonas Korpisalo.
It was a really nice save.
Here, Luc Dubois back the other way, pass in front, trying to play off the defender, and I think, but was held out of the net. And it's a 2-on-1 the other way. Virtanen pass in front, broken up by the goaltender. And here he comes again across the blue line. Jake Virtanen back to the point. Long shot, puckered away by the goaltender. And Pierre-Luc Dubois can escape to center. Late in the second period. Back comes Virtanen down the left wing, into the slot, trying to drop it back to the circle. Broken up on the back check. Pierre-Luc Dubois can work his way up the ice again. Through the middle, wrist shot. Goes wide on the stick under. Now back in front, and another one-time opportunity. Gloves save that time.
Good opportunities coming to plays. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
what do you got to do different here to actually get it into the back of the net?
No, I have, I don't know, three scoring chances. I had 18 shots last game, so yeah, we have to play better defensively because four goals. I don't know if I can score five. I'm not gonna lie. Come on, boys.
30 seconds left in the second period.
Come on.
And the clock will wind down here with Jake Virtanen lead by three goals going to the third period. So still time left. You said earlier, Jake, PLD was a third period player. He's going to need to be to try and battle back here.
Yeah, I got to make sure I'm good defensively here. I know that last game he came back and had a big comeback win, so I got to make sure I'm on point here in the third period. So, wait.
And here we go, period time.
Too many goals.
Right. Jake Virtanen and Pierre-Luc Dubois here. Battling it out. The final of the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Geeks. Another chance in front for Virtanen. First minute of the third period. He's had a couple of goals early on in periods and nearly had another one there, but it was stopped in front. Again, we remind you, And thank you for joining us. If you want to make a donation to help frontline workers through Canada Helps, click the link below the stream. Or for more information, you can go to CanadaHelps.org. Thank our sponsors as well. Shaw, Red Bull, EB Games, GameStop, and AccuSpike. Chance for Pierre-Luc Dubois going to the net. Odd man rush, elected to shoot, and couldn't in the back of the goal. Now here's a look into the slot, and a clapper goes wide, high on the stick side. Trying to mount a comeback here. But Jake Virtanen cuts in front again. That was nearly a one-time tapping chance at the back door. Couldn't get it go though. Now a three-on-one in front. And it just goes wide of the net. Now top of the crease. Puck loose there again, but Jake Virtanen's able to clear and come up ice. Virtanen.
You guys are going to start seeing poke checks.
Uh-oh. Which means we're going to be seeing a penalty here very shortly.
Yeah. It's a matter of time.
Oh, Bass. Come on.
Able to force the turnover there, though.
No.
And cutting back to the left circle. Just handled the puck. It's Jake Virtanen ahead again. Down the right way. In front. Stopped by Korpisalo as Canucks crash the net there.
Goalie's playing well on both ends. I think PLD's had maybe three or four solid chances and just pucks going maybe a foot or so wide in by the post. Just not able to get it to go right now. Now Jake just needs to hold on to this lead for the next 12 minutes and he is a champion. We'll see what PLD has though.
I just changed my tactics. So we're gonna be seeing offense from the Jackets.
And here they come in across the line. Another good look in the slot. Still held out of the net. And Virtanen back the other way with Timbers in the rush. Just moved down the left wing. Trying to hold on to the puck. Knocked loose by Dubois. And back he comes again into the slot. Deeking. Shooting. And stopped by Markstrom. Nice little move there to create some space through the middle of the ice. Here, Luke having a tough time solving Jacob Markstrom in the Canuck net right now. With time continuing to tick down on the clock.
There it is.
And there's the tripping penalty.
Every time. All right. We play better than you can anyway. But
you had to get aggressive and try to get that puck speed up the ice.
So power play opportunity for Jake Virtanen to continue to extend his lead, but instead it's Dubois back the other way shorthanded. Trying to cut to the net, had a defender draped all over him, but got the shot loose anyway. And another save by Jacob Markstrom. Offensive zone draw on the PK. At what point do you think about pulling your goalie here, PLD?
I got no.
Charging penalty this time? Oh, boarding.
Now it's a boarding. Well, you can't pull the goalie now. Now he's in trouble. Gotta kill this thing off.
He's gotta kill it off and then pull it. Oh, on. That's.
Wow, Lenny from behind, the helmet pops off.
CD?
A little violent. Sweet on sweet aggression.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Come on.
Now, do you need to see some pushback, Jake, after that hit, or do you just score on the power play and make him pay? Oh, no, we got to responding to the hit, and both of them coming out flying with right hands.
Oh, and
connecting.
So
no one defending, just a free-for-all. And down goes Foligno as Jake Virtanen wins the scrap. But the question is, has that sparked the Columbus bench? Oh.
Not at all. Nick Foligno, the big loss. Come on, Flicks. No defense.
Yeah, so Jake actually does get a little energy boost there as well. His lines are going to be at full energy. Whereas LD, he's still got those red and yellow bars on the energy bar. So going to be a tough PK here for the rest of the time. He's got to kill this thing off and get back to offense as soon as possible.
It's going to be risky.
Bertan and a hit on the power play. Okay. Pass to the back door. There's another one. 5-1 with the power play goal right after the scrap.
Could that be the dagger?
I guess.
I have seen crazier comebacks than this. There's still a chance. He's just got to get one early. Now, we saw Jake score off the draw many times. He's already done it twice so far in this broadcast. We need PLD to grab a quick one here if he wants any sort of chance at winning this thing.
I'm still 5-1-4. We're good. Alright. That's where it happened last game. Let's go that.
As Dubois has the puck, trying to spring his forward in on a breakaway, but instead Vertanen picks it off and he's back into the attacking zone. Tried a shot from a tight angle, held out by the goaltender. As the power play is an end, not a lot of time left in the game. Under 5 minutes. A 5-1 hockey game for Jake Vertanen as Dubois crashes the net down the right wing there.
Another
puck is still held out, and there's a tripping penalty for Pierre-Luc Dubois again. I guess you got to just try it right now when you're trailing.
I got nothing to lose. I need the puck back.
D-zone face-off win. But the puck is turned over, and Jake Vertanen has it into the slot. One-timer through some traffic. And Korpisalo made the save there. 5-1 game here, the final of the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium.
It's a little too late to start winning jobs.
Face-off win means Pierre-Luc Dubois gains the attacking blue line, but can't create a chance. And now it's iced by Jake Vertanen. Vertanen back up the ice, looking to build on the 4-goal lead. Late on in the third period here now. But does Pierre-Luc Dubois have a comeback in him? Into the slot. Tries a shot. It's blocked.
Oh, no.
And Vertanen clears again. Back comes Dubois offside with a man caught deep in the zone.
4 goals, 1 minute. Had ever been done. And could today be the day? I don't think TLD's feeling too confident right now.
Never too late. We just four quick ones, and we're back.
All you need is one to start it.
I gotta go low.
Long shot, rebound, loose, played free. And now Vertanen, 2-on-0 to finish it. Pass is broken up. It's still there in the slot. Fired towards the net and blocked. 30 seconds left here in the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. Tannen going to the goal, pass across to the right circle. Trying to add yet another goal, and he'll do just that off the post and in. It's 6-1 with 16 seconds left.
That's embarrassing. I had a penalty too, by the way. Delayed penalty also, so. So I guess Chavi was terrible. I guess Sagan was pretty good. I was confident coming into this one.
So let's start you, Pierre-Luc, as the game winds down here. Maybe a chance to get a goal. Just fired wide. And a power play to the Blue Jackets. So Jake Vertanen takes a penalty. Pretty disciplined thus far. But in the late stages, he'll go to the box. And again, look at the faceoff numbers there. 23-6. in favor of Jake Virtanen.
Dubois taking
and that is the end of the game. Jake Virtanen wins the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge presented by the Gaming Stadium. Pierre-Luc Dubois loses in the final 6-1. And let's start with you, Pierre-Luc. How do you feel about your performance overall on the day? In the semifinal, you have a thrilling finish to the game. You win it in overtime. You're riding high, but the final doesn't go your way.
Yeah, a little embarrassed, to be honest. I was coming in with a lot of energy. I thought I could honestly win, and not only did I lose, but I got embarrassed. So I have to reevaluate myself here.
Meanwhile, Jake Virtanen, the champion of the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge. How does that sound?
Well, it's a good feeling. Yesterday, last night, when I played the computer and lost, I was a little bit nervous coming in today because I thought I was going to get smacked around, sure. But no, I'm happy I had two wins today. First one was pretty easy, and this was definitely a little bit better. It was pretty fun game, though, today so far.
All right, guys. Well, thanks for joining us. Really appreciate you taking part and helping to raise money for frontline workers. Congratulations, Jake. And thanks a lot again, Pierre-Luc Dubois.
Thanks, guys.
There they are, Jake Virtanen and Pierre-Luc Dubois. Jake Virtanen wins the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge with a decisive victory in the final, no less, Nasher.
Yeah, how about that one? I thought PLD had it in him, especially after coming back in the game prior, but unfortunately, Jake, especially with those faceoffs, I think that was really the difference maker in this game. He scored 30 seconds in, was able to bury it, and really just kept that lead for the entire game. What a showing from all these guys, though. Big thanks to all of them for hopping on. Could not have asked for a better tournament here.
And again, we'll remind you, you can go to CanadaHelps.org or click the link below the stream if you want to donate to help frontline workers. One last thank you to our sponsors, Shaw, Red Bull, EB Games, GameStop, and AccuSpike. And again, visit thegamingstadium.com for more info on a variety of online esports tournaments taking place regularly. Thanks again for joining us here. Jake Virtanen wins the Shaw Online Hockey Challenge. Thanks for being Nasher. That was a lot of fun. And goodbye for now.
Skate. The Star is able to get one ahead for Tyler Seguin with 33 goals and 80 points last season.
Oh my God,
and what a play that was.
Have a 2-0 league, and Tyler Seguin, who's one of the most talented offensive players in this game, makes a beautiful move on Larkin.
Gaudette works his way back to the blue line, leaves for Ben. Jordy Ben with a wrist shot blocked, and now he's got to hustle back. Four Stars to center. Seguin leading the way on the left wing. Drop pass, Pavelski across, Seguin scores! It came off Haskinen and right to him. And and Tyler Seguin had a tap in to make it 3-2 Dallas.
Get that shot through, and now you're scrambling. Everybody's scrambling. Haskinen reads this play very well. He jumps up. I don't think he meant that to be.
Bird rolling up the boards. Tyler Seguin's here for it. Mete is back. Seguin waits. Backhander scores! That fool's carry, but you got to respect the shot, first of all, from Seguin, because he could score from that right-hand position.
Michael Ferland. Ferland moving in on Gudas. Throws on the brakes. Passes back. Bo Horvat centers the puck for 10 and scores! It's happy hour!
Vertanen gets it forward for Zach McEwen. McEwen to the middle. Vertanen is in, trying to tuck it home. He scores!
On deck for Vancouver, getting a pass through, and a goal by Vertanen. And just like that, the Canucks
keep it down low. The pass was in behind Antoine Roussel as Vancouver's changed up its personnel. Myers walks in. Here's a shot. Scores!
So Canucks are on the board. Shots are now 9-1. And here's a turnover and a chance. Vertanen stuffed by Quick. Rebound scores.
The Hurricanes' Joel Edmondson. Now Brock McGinn for Edmondson. Broken up by Nyquist. He tries to spring Dubois. Pierre-Luc Dubois is in. He scores!
Left hand to help out on the separation. I mean, back in the second period, that could have been called a hold. And he is able to ward off McGinn and make a power move with it.
Dubois, try to work a give and go. He's going to get there. Open net against Leonard, and he poked it home. Pierre-Luc Dubois.
Dubois got inside position on Connor Murphy. And then he helped himself out where he kind of slingshot himself, partner. Dubois, headman's at puck to Nyquist. Nyquist sprints down. Dubois scores! Jackets win it overtime.
With authority, right over the shoulder. It's a give and go. Dubois, Nyquist, Dubois.
Back the other way. Brown with a wrist shot. Jay Fleury up high. Rebound to Tierney. He'll feed it out high. Shabbat curled and drives and scores. What a move by Thomas Shabbat. Cut his way to the middle and goes upstairs on Marc-Andre Fleury.
What a chance at the other end. First for Pacioretty, but the little glimpse into the talent that Thomas Shabbat has. Watch a little toe drag around Stastny. Curl drag, release, top corner. It's a beautiful goal by the defenseman of Ottawa to tie.
Well, it continues as the Sens come back up the ice. Here's Shabbat, straight up the middle. Shabbat scores! What a goal, Thomas Shabbat!
And he's going to go right through the Boston defense corps right there and goes top shelf on Rask. And what I like about this is his patience. He sees Carlo coming. He recognizes Carlo's got a long reach, so he lays the...
What a slick play by Brown, and it nearly results in the equalizer. Scores! Thomas Shabbat got the equalizer!
Severson can't clear it, goes right up the middle.